Hello and welcome to News and Views. I'm John Banville. Our guest this week is Senator Marty Golden. Senator Golden, thank you very much for being here.
John, how are you?
I'm doing well. Good. We had been discussing the state budget. It had been a proposal made by Governor Cuomo, and we were in the process of negotiating a state budget. And you had several concerns about making sure that Hurricane Sandy relief was in there, that tax cuts were in there, that we kept a line on spending. The state budget has been passed for the third time in a row on time. And I'd like to know a few of you, I'd like to know how you feel this budget impacts the New Yorkers New Yorkers across our state, and how you feel the ultimate product came out. Did we achieve what you wanted to achieve as part of this state budget?
Well, it's always difficult to achieve the goals that you anticipate, that you want to see happen for the communities in Brooklyn and across our city and state. But in this particular bill and this budget, we were able to, I think, accommodate a lot of different issues. And the most important issue was keeping taxes down and making sure that we gave the working class, the middle class families, the opportunity to stay and live and raise their families in Brooklyn. So we worked extremely hard to make sure that we put additional credits out there, $350 tax credit that'll go to each and every middle class home across our city and state. We kept $800 million that we're going to be able to use into small businesses and make sure that we identify needs for our small businesses and make sure that they're able to provide jobs. That's the big thing, is being able to provide those jobs. We made sure we kept STAR, and we added to STAR and the enhanced STAR, and that's the exemption on your homes to make sure that you have the ability to be able to stay in your home and get that tax relief. So we added $300 million there. So we were, I thought, very, very good in making sure that we did that. We also, like I said, we put that $800 million into into our small businesses. And we just put together a good pro-family, a pro-business bill that kept spending down. We have a 2% cap across the state. We stayed within that 2% cap. And we were able to not affect, as a matter of fact, make sure we took care of education and took care of public safety and went after the MTA and make sure that we have dollars available for their construction to make sure that we deal with the Sandy issues. Sandy, never going away. Sandy is one of those lingering situations that have impacted families across the Brooklyn and Queens and Staten Island and into Westchester and Nassau County, Suffolk County. So what we have to be able to do is put the package together, which is still being formulated, and hopefully within the next few weeks there'll be an announcement as to how much money is going to go out to the families for relief to be able to raise their homes so that they can stay in their communities and to be able to rebuild their homes. So we were thankful in this budget to make sure that we kept the $136 billion plus the $5 billion from the state, from the federal government for the FEMA and for the people that were affected by Sandy. And we were instrumental in making sure now that we've given out a good number of that money to the people in Sandy relief to make sure that they have that opportunity to stay in their homes and rebuild those homes. Moving over to the equations for the education. There was a bitter contest between the mayor and the UFT over being able to have teacher evaluations. They did never, they were one of the five districts that did not get that done across the state, and they were penalized for that, $240 million, and they would have penalized another $240 million next year. It would have been a total of almost $500 million, and going forward, they would have lost much, much more and over $1 billion in the next 3 to 4 years. We were able to negotiate with this governor and to not only make sure we put them back in a baseline, they don't lose the $240 million for next year and don't lose any money in the out years going out. But we were also able to put in almost $1 billion into education across the board, which gave us the almost $280 million that we have the ability to distribute to our schools and to make sure that it's not a makeup for the $240 million we lost. I would have liked to have the $240 plus this $280 million, but that's not going to happen. But we did get $280 million, first time ever real increase, and that's good for all of our schools, our public, our privates, and our parochials. We looked very closely to make sure. We also worked with Chuck Fasciullo in Long Island in the Department of Transportation. He's got the issues with the MTA and the roads, and we were maybe for the first time we've actually seen an increase in getting our roads enhanced, $80 million plus another $15 million on top of that. First time ever that we've seen an increase in roads in the city of New York, and nobody got to tell us better than in my communities. In Bay Ridge, we have a sinkhole that went in there 8 months ago, and we're just on 92nd Street and 3rd Avenue, just coming to the end of that, and we're going to see the repaving of that over the next couple of weeks, and that will be finished. But all my infrastructure is 100 years old. So that sinkhole that we had in Bay Ridge, a tree actually went right into it. It could have been a human being. In this particular case, it was a tree. The tree was gone. It was like that poor guy that died down in Midwest in Florida, and he disappeared, and they never found him. Well, we had that same particular sinkhole. And we want to make sure that there's money there for the infrastructure to make sure we don't have those issues. We made sure we covered the MTA, like I said before, to make sure that the dollars there, not only for the capital money, but for the operating dollars, to make sure we have the ability to get our people back and forth to work, and our express buses to make sure that they're operating and operating at their best. We made sure that we dealt with one of the most important issues, and it was very sad to leave here. When we had passed the budget, we had cut, the governor had cut $120 million out of the physically and mentally handicapped. Wrong thing to do. All these residencies across our communities don't need a cut of $120 million. They needed more dollars to be able to access so that they get proper care and good care. These are our families, our brothers, our sisters, our nieces, our nephews. And here's the unfortunate reality. That $120 million was actually a $240 million cut because there was another $120 million on the federal side. So we managed to put $30 million back, which took $60 million off, which left it to be a $180 million cut. Nobody, no agency could sustain that. We had an agreement from the governor that he would work these numbers and they would come up with a way to be less egregious on this $180 million. And I'm happy to announce that the governor in the past week has sat down with these not-for-profits in the city and the state and has worked out a deal. I think the total cut, and I believe this is the total cut, is $22 million. So to be able to bring a $240 million cut down to $22 million, still a significant hit for those institutions, but what a savings at the end of the day. What a you know, a relief to all of these families. So those are the areas that we really worked hard, making sure also we put money into our colleges and money into our incubators and into film tax credits to be able to increase revenues in so that we can have a better bottom line and be able to put people to work.
I wanted to actually go back to a couple of the programs you just spoke about, the incubators and the film tax credit. We had been discussing the film tax credit a few weeks ago, and there were some, at this point in time, we were still negotiating whether it would be a 3-year program, whether it would be a 5-year program, or even in some cases, if there would be a program at all. The final state budget, what happened with the film tax credit? Is it in there, and for how long?
It's in there for a 5-year period. It's a $420 million tax credit. And it's a tax credit that went from just under $5 billion, and it's over $8 billion today. 140,000 people went to work last year with this tax credit. That's what you want. That's real tax credit that's doing real work and putting people to work across our city and our state. So I just got a call. You're going to laugh. John Flanagan, Senator Flanagan, was visiting down in Steiner Studios this past week, and he gave me a call on the phone. He said, you know, Marty, you really never get a chance to call a fellow senator, and you tell him, you know, what good's going on and what greatness has come out of some things that you've accomplished. It's usually to call a complaint, can you take care of this, can you take care of that, I got a problem here, I got an issue there. He says, but I was mesmerized by the work that we've been able to do in Brooklyn Stages, Kaufman, and Silver Cup, and of course Steiner Studios, and all the work that we've been able to bring in to our city and create those jobs. And believe me, it's working extremely well.
Did just to explain to our viewers at home, how does the tax credit work? I understand that it encourages studios to come in and film movies in New York City, but it really has a ripple effect on the entire community, because when it creates jobs, the restaurants end up getting more money, the coffee places. It really is a very interesting thing. Can you describe this to us a little bit?
It's so big that it's and it has that ripple effect. We don't pay, obviously, the actors, and we don't pay anything out of our tax credit. What we do is we do cover some of the salaries as it relates to the below the line, the construction, the building of the stages, all of the art design. And so we give a 30% tax credit, and some will say, well, you know, that's pretty significant, a 30% tax credit. Do they really need it? Well, we went to competition with Canada. Canada was eating our lunch. This tax credit brought that business back here. New Jersey was eating our lunch. They were doing a backdrop as the city of New York, and nobody was doing shooting in the city of New York years ago. We've reversed that. California, $30 billion industry. I wasn't going to war with California. I was just trying to keep what we deserve to have here in the city and state of New York. Well, anyway, the California got so upset with us, they did a $500 million tax credit as well, and guess what? We have the best tax credit with the best results, with the best return on investment than any other tax credit. There were 40 states with tax credits today since we started this, and not one of them is working as well as the one in New York. And it does have that ripple effect. Everybody goes to work, and it's just one of those good tax credits.
There was $1.25 million that you obtained in this year's state budget to facilitate incubators. Now, can you, I know that this is a project that you've worked on very diligently for a number of years, and that incubators are growing more jobs than any other program right now in New York State. But a lot of our viewers don't know what incubators are. They think it has something to do with chickens. Can you tell our viewers at home what this does?
An incubator gives an opportunity for a talented individual that's come out of a college, a master's degree, a PhD, still in college, but a lot of them are out of college and have created their own or looking to create their own apps and their own ideas and technology and the future of technology, but they don't have the resources to set up an office in Madison Avenue. So what you do is you set up these hubs and hotspots around the city. And we're working with the governor of the state of New York to do this. We have one, it's unbelievable. He's got like maybe 1,000 people belong to it. And you get different rents that you pay. And if you're there by yourself, you got the ability to talk to other talented people in technology that know technology well and get the ability to work with their talents. You're a little bit better, you pay a little bit higher rent where you have 3 or 4 or 5 people working for you. And then it's a little bit higher when you get to about 15 people. And then you really start to, you know, springboard out of that and into your own business, into your own office space. And you got to see people from Google and Yahoo coming down and sapping these people up left and right because they know that's where the talent is. And then you have another 1,500 people that live within a 5-block area of this hub. And what they do is they use this on a regular basis and they do all networking and they're able to create jobs that we're able to keep here in our city and in Brooklyn and in New York City. And that's what these incubators are. They give that technology, the best and the brightest, they put them together, and they come up with these consortiums of different environments, different ideas, whether it is a new app, which is a new design on a computer, you know, if it's designing, you know, the technology for distribution of gas, a distribution of energy, and they come up with these ideas and this setting, and they take these ideas forward, and all these major companies come in and buy this talent up and keep these people working here in our city. It is a avenue for success, and it's an avenue that's actually putting real people to work, getting real investment into our city, and giving the opportunity for these people to blossom and to stay here. And they come from all over the world. Go to our schools, our colleges. Now we have the ability to keep them here. And I think it's great.
Senator Golden, that's all the time we have for this week. I'd like to have you back in the future. We can discuss some of the issues facing our state and how they're going to affect Brooklyn.
Thank you.
I want to thank you very much. We'll see you soon.